Good morning, good morning. Happy Wednesday. Today is Wednesday, August 3rd. Welcome to Energized Life. This is where we make magic in the mornings and we have conversations and we connect. And today is episode 201. So happy, happy Wednesday. Thank you so much for being here. Listen, if you are showing up at 6:18 Eastern Standard Time for an Energized Life, if you are showing up at 6:18 a.m., you are the kind of person who wants to have good conversation, who wants to be around other people who want to have good conversation. You are a high-vibe person. Like, you need to take your hand and put it on your back and already give yourself a pat on the back. Already give yourself a pat on the back because you are already slaying the day. If on 6:18 on a Wednesday morning, you are here with other high vibe people. Like, that is a big deal. Lots of people say they want to grow. Lots of people say they want to change. Lots of people don't do anything about it. You are. So give yourself a pat on the back and some credit. We have Harry joining us this morning. Give it up for Harry Styles, ladies and gentlemen. Give it up for Harry Styles. Harry's joining us this morning. I have the cutest new cup. I already made my first thing on it. This cup already made its debut on social media. It's already been out. But let's get it turned around so you can truly. I mean, what? What is that? Is that not the cutest thing in the entire world? It already made its debut on social. It's already been out there. This is what I made my first thing in this morning. I mean, I'm just collecting them. I'm just my cup collection. I love cups. I mean, let's just stop fighting it, all right? Let's just stop fighting it. I don't need some big expensive purse. I carry a Lululemon belt bag, right? Like, I don't need some big expensive purse. I'd rather have a cup. Here we go. Here we go. We do have to get outside. Kind of, I left Lady outside. She went outside and then I left her outside. You know what? I left it. It's what it is. So let's make some energize. And let's go outside. If you're not drinking strawberry lemonade energize, who are you? Who are you? You need to get off this Instagram live right now and go over to either your favorite Team Beachbody coach or your Team Beachbody coach account and get yourself some strawberry lemonade energize and stop playing around. Like, I don't even know what you're doing. So we're gonna make this energize. And we're gonna go outside. Alexa off. Because Lady's standing out there waiting for me. And very soon she's gonna start scratching. And we don't need her scratching on the screen. How is everyone this morning? How are we doing? We had big time storms yesterday here in Florida. We had some big storms. We watched quite the lightning show yesterday. We went over to Coronado Springs Resort, which is where we got said cute cup. I mean, look at it again. It's so stinking cute. Little sunrise and energized frother, thanks to Chris. And we just watched a lightning show yesterday. It was Mother Nature. Spectacular. We thought we were going to wait it out, and then we started driving home and it was like a monsoon. I was driving home in a monsoon, so, and I already can't see, so it's like I need to wear a sign around me that says, I can't see you if you're more than like 5 feet away from me. I don't know who you are, okay? Really, like, my eyes are bad. And listen, every time I talk about my eyes, this is funny. Women are so funny. Every time I talk about my eyes and how poor my vision is, you all know, like, I'm not 12. Like, I've been on the planet for a while, okay? Every time I talk about my eyes, people are like, well, have you tried this? Have you tried this? I'm like, do you not think I've tried these things? I have very, very poor vision. I have a cousin who's directly across from me in the genealogical lineage who is actually blind. So we have poor vision in our family. I got my first pair of contacts the summer before I turned 8 years old. So they're bad, and I can't see. So I feel like I need to wear a sign that says, if you're somewhere and we're out and about, if you do not literally come up to me and go, "Hi, I'm blah, blah, blah," I will not see you. I will not know who you are. It is what it is. My point being is, I can't see you very well, and then I drove home in a monsoon, and we're all just lucky that I'm alive this morning, okay? That's what I'm saying. So this morning, I got our paper out again, and by far, it's a page and a half of behind the scenes of how you built your business, more behind the scenes of how you built your business, more behind the scenes how you built your business, building your business, how you built your business, more on how you built your business, building your business. I get the impression, correct me if I'm wrong, but I get the impression you would like to talk about building a business. I'm just assuming that maybe I'm crazy, but I'm gonna assume that that's something that is something that you would like to talk about. If so, in the comments right now, say yes or no. Yay or nay, thumbs up, thumbs down, whatever. Like, it's a page and a half of literally building a business. More behind the scenes of how you built your business. How you built your business, please. How you built your business with an exclamation mark. An exclamation mark. Meg, I mean, it doesn't take any intuition whatsoever to discern that perhaps you would like to talk about how I built my business. Now, here's where you have to show up. Here's where you have to show up. You can't just be like, "How do I build my business?" And then JV shows up and knows what you mean by that. I need to know what you mean by that. So, Ashley, thank you. Thank you so much. You're very kind. I would love to know, what do you mean by that? What does that mean? How you built your business? Because what about building the business that I have built, the business that I am in, the business that many of you who are connected here via Energized Life are in, what about it feels mysterious or nebulous or unclear to you? If you could figure that out, I might be able to better answer your questions. But how I built my business is such a vague, broad, it's a broad stroke question that I don't even know how to start to answer that, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna take a sip of my Energize. We're gonna get this lid on, and then we'll go outside. And while we're doing all that, can you better clarify what you mean by that while we're doing all that? And if you can't, then I don't know how to answer that question. I'm just saying, I'm volleying that right back to you. Lid on. Oh, I'm not saying what it's saying and what has changed. Okay, Meg, that's better. Meg, do me a favor. That's a great question. Take that question and put it over in the question box so that I can go back to it and it doesn't get lost in the comments. Deb, do the same thing. Take your question, put it over in the question box so it doesn't get lost in the comments. What would be amazing is if you could save the questions after the live so you could come back to them. I'm coming, lady. We're coming. We're coming. So take those questions and put them in the question box. But listen. Listen to me right now. How I built my business, that's a cop-out question. If you can't elucidate, if you cannot clarify what you mean by that, it's not an actual question. I said what I said. So until you can clarify what you mean by how you built your business, I don't have anything to answer, you know? There's nothing to answer there. So, good morning, Sawyer, who barked and howled. Can you see or no? It's too dark. Who barked and howled all night long. There's nothing worse than being woken up by a beagle howling. Oh, my gosh. I don't know if you'll be able to see this. Listen. Oh, can you see that? Hold on. You see that right there. Do you see that? Oh, that's
That's incredible right there. Right there. It's just barely starting to come up. Hi, lady. We see you. Look at that. It's stunning. What is the temperature outside? It is a little bit... Do I need a jacket? Lives in Florida for 5 months, and the temperature is 80 and needs a jacket. That's me. I know. Isn't it gorgeous? Let me turn it so you can see. I mean, it's just so stunning. It's just so stunning. Katie Graham, do you have a beagle? It takes a special person to have beagles. It does. I'm a special person. No, you just have to have a lot of patience. They're a lot. They are a lot. Okay, I'm going in the question box. Oh my gosh. Brittany Perkins, no. We'll come back to that. Okay, Meg Slope. What is something you did to get started that has stayed, and what have you changed? What have you changed as the business has grown? Awesome question. What is something I did when I started my business, and what has stayed? So in terms of, again, I think more I don't really think in granular terms. I think more in mindset terms. I guess that's what I'm trying to say. So what is something that I did when I started and something that has stayed with me? Okay. Something I did when I started and something that has stayed with me, number one, is I have no plan B. I do not have my hand on the back door. I am not looking for a way out. I never said, I'm going to try this for a little while. I never gave myself a trial period. There was no, if this doesn't work, I'm out. There was absolutely none of that. I entered this business like I entered marriage. We're going to figure it out. It's not going to be puppies and unicorns, and we're going to figure it out. And there's no plan B. I do not have my hand on a back door. I do not have one foot in and one foot out. I've never at any point in time ever said, I think I'm going to cancel my coach account. I've never tried the business. There's never been a trial period. I've never said, if this doesn't work in 6 months, I'm out. Nothing. That has never been my attitude. Not one time in 14 years. I joined as a coach. Okay, let's figure it out. I went into it like I did marriage. I went into it like I did parenting. That was my mindset when I started, and it is still my mindset today. And it was my mindset when I started in 2008, where there were zero success stories. The business was too new. The only success stories there were fitness success stories, and they were all P90X, and I was a turbo girl. So you know how we say you have to see it to be it? And in 2022, if you think you can't build this business, you're just lying to yourself, because there are so many examples of success stories that you just finally have to decide how many you're going to see before you write your own. In 2008, that did not exist. There was just something that told me that I'm going to go in. Everything about this business aligns with what I love. I love health and fitness. I love movement. I love community. I love people. I love helping people. I love personal growth. And quite frankly, I like making money. So why would I ever leave? Why would I ever say I'm going to give myself a trial? You know, I think of it in terms of my husband, who was a college football coach. Could there be any riskier job, right? There's no riskier job than let me go get a career based on 18-year-old young men catching a ball who probably went out to quarter beers the night before. Let me build a career on that, right? There's no riskier job than that. And at no point in time in our marriage have I said, you know what? If you don't win a conference championship, you're done with this situation. You got to quit this job. At no point in time did my husband go, you know what? If I don't win a conference championship, I'm out. Like, this was his passion. This is his passion. This was my passion. So even though I had absolutely no idea what this business was going to do in my life, it is still doing on the daily. Let's get really granular. I'm just thinking about this week, conversations I've had and growth that I feel that I'm going through 14 years into the business that would not be happening had I not said yes 14 years ago. So I had no idea what this business would do, how much it would change my life. I just knew there was no plan B. So Meg, yes or no, does that answer your question? Let me go back to the question box. Brooke, what's being delegated in your business? What are you focusing on with your new and rockstar coaches? What's being delegated in your business? So Brooke, you've probably heard me say 8 gazillion times, this business is a business of 4 activities. You press play, you drink a shake, you read a book, you invite people to join you. People who make it more complicated than that are looking for an out. They're looking for a way to not build. They're getting in their own way. This is what this business is. I'm gonna press play, drink a shake, read a book, and invite people to join me. So as I grow, as my team grows, as I grow in leadership, and as my goals grow, there are some pieces that I simply don't do because they're just not in my spiritual giftings. Do you know what's not in my spiritual giftings? Making graphics. That is not in my spiritual giftings. Do you know what is not in my spiritual giftings? Designing a website, all right? Do you know what else is not in my spiritual giftings? Making merchandise. So I am not going to do those things that are not in my spiritual giftings. Do you know that you know what else is not? This is a great example. Do you know what else is not my spiritual giftings? Budgeting and figuring out money. That is not my spiritual giftings. But Emily, my accountant, who's also a coach on my team, that is her very much spiritual gifting and helping me stay on track with long-term vision. Do you know what's not in Emily's spiritual giftings? Getting on Instagram Live every morning. Everybody has spiritual giftings. So why would it be any different? Think about in parenting, if you are a two-parent family, or if you were a two-parent family at some point, or you've got, you know, people that help you co-parent, whatever that might be, there are spiritual giftings that my husband has that I did not have. Like when we parent, he is like the game guy. He's like, let's make a game out of it and let's keep score and like all the game. I mean, it makes sense, right? Like he's the game guy and playing the games and keeping score and doing all, playing cards and just games. I'd rather poke my eyeball out. But what I will do is take you and to every experience. I will take you to story time. We will go walk around the zoo. We will do like, I'm an experience person. He'd rather poke his eyeball out. So we work in our spiritual giftings as parents. I'm gonna work in my spiritual giftings as a coach. My spiritual gifting is teaching, mentoring, speaking. So it's not making graphics. So that is something that I delegate. Making my website, I'm not doing that, you know? And you just have to really get clear on what is your spiritual gifting and what do you love to do? And what's cool is there are other people who love to do the thing that you don't. Also, you have to see, this is absolutely incredible. Like, can you even, I wish you could see this as much. It is, and then over here, look over there. Look at that. Look at that. Okay, sorry, I had to digress. It's just too gorgeous. And also, if you are not hiring someone to help you and you want to grow your business and you're not hiring someone to help you, that's ego that's in the way. It's just ego. So that's on you. Is Julia Stack on here? Because Julia hired an assistant for her dog grooming business. She hemmed and hawed about it for far too long. She was definitely in her own way. And it was definitely her ego. We've talked about this. Julie's in my Compass coaching program, and we've talked about this. She hired an assistant, and she made more money in the week that she hired her assistant than she did before hiring her assistant. Delegate. It's ego if you're not delegating. Okay. Brooke, does that help? Does that help? Deborah Allen says, this is not a silly question, but it's almost silly when I think about it because of how much it's changed. When I first started coaching, how did I share and connect about it compared to now with social media? Okay, as I've said before, when I first started coaching, I was on MySpace. Okay, so all you babies who were born like yesterday, who don't know any kind of life without Instagram, listen. I was on MySpace, and then here, this is crazy. You ready to have your mind blown? Here we go. Your mind is about to be blown. I talk to people in real life. I had actual conversations with people on the phone and in real life. What? Now, the beautiful thing is, with social media now, we get to have conversations with people who are all over the world that I would never meet, that you would never meet, in real life. We would never meet each other in real life. We have a friend on here who's from Puerto Rico. We have our friend Cool Julesy, who's in the UK. We've got people who are, across the pond. We would never meet them in real life, likely. So the benefit of social media now is that we get to make such a greater impact and we get to find our people. Because remember, what's our quest in life? To find our people. Our quest is to find our people. I think where people get hung up in social media, and you know this, you already know this because we talk about it so much, is putting on a show and being performative on social media. There's nothing more gross to me than performative posts, being performative. Let me post this because of how it makes me look, being performative on social media. No wonder you can't build a business. You're trying to perform. You're not even authentic. Nobody knows who the hell you are. So that has been a journey of really showing up even more authentically. I think personally, over the past 3 years, let me say this. One of my favorite activities to do is to pull up memories on Facebook. Because we went from MySpace to Facebook to Instagram. Okay? The activities are the same. It's just the platforms changed. And the breadth and width of it, the people that we get to connect with now is much more. But we've just moved from one platform to the next, right? Technology getting better. One of my favorite things to do in the morning when I'm in my messages and I'm on Facebook in the morning is to pull up memories and look at posts from 10, 12, 13 years ago. And listen to me, I could have written those posts today. It will be a post about my team, Sparta Nation. It'll be a post about fitness and how it makes me feel. It'll be a post about my business and what it's doing in my life. When I look back at 10, 12, 13 years ago and I pull up those Facebook memories, I could write some of those posts today. Listen to me, that's not talent, that's not creativity, that's not intelligence. That is showing up every single day, sharing what you love, period. That is showing up every, there is not one day that I will go back to where I don't have a post of some kind because I show up every single day. That's what builds a business. It doesn't matter what platform you're on, showing up every single day and being authentically you, not performatively you, being authentically you, that's what will build a business. And when I pull up those Facebook memories and I see that I'm posting the same thing today practically that I did 10 years ago, I just want my coaches and I want the network to understand this business is built on consistency. It's not MySpace anymore, it's not Facebook anymore, it's Instagram now, but Instagram's always changing. Maybe it's TikTok, maybe it's this, but what are you doing every single freaking day to add value and to help people. Can you go back 10 years ago or however long you've been a coach and go, oh yes, I have been posting about that my entire life. It's really hard to argue with someone about the value of the shake they drink when they've been posting about it for 13 years. It's really hard to argue with someone that they think fitness is important when they've been posting about it for 15 years. It's really hard to argue with someone that this business can change their life when they've been posting about it for 14 years. 14 years I've been telling people that this business can change your life. It's really hard to argue with someone. Like, that's not performative, that's authentic. Are you showing up on social media, and I don't care what platform you're on, in an authentic way, not a performative way, in an authentic way? And I think, going back to my original point, over the last 3 years, having gone through a pandemic, having dug deep, deep, deep into intentional mindset work even more than I ever have, asking myself hard questions, having hard conversations, talking with human beings, and being so intentional about trying to level up, I feel like I have shed the baggage of other people's opinions, and now I don't give a freak if you like me or not. This is what I believe. And I'm on a quest to find my people. So if I am showing up being performative on social media, how am I ever gonna find my people? Because at some point, you can't keep up that performance. But listen to me, it's really hard to argue with someone who's been posting about how fitness can change your life for 14 years. It's really hard to argue with someone who's been posting about how this business can change your life for 14 years. Why don't you show up and be you? Because your quest is to find your people, not to find worky coaches or to find people who want to build the business. Your quest is to find people like you, humans on a mission to create their life on purpose of purpose. How can you find them if you're not being yourself, if you're showing up and being performative? How can you find them if you're not showing up and sharing your real, true beliefs? That does not mean you got to tell everybody your deepest, darkest secrets or everything that's happening in your life. But if you are not showing up, sharing who you are and what you believe every single day, not just when you feel like it, every single day, how are you finding your people? I don't care what business you're in. How are you finding your people? How are you finding your people? That's our quest. We're on a quest to find our people. And I'm going to say this. And I hope this comes out correctly. I'm going to say this, just talking about finding your people. The business has been around for a very long time. 25 years, okay, 21 years, something like that. Like, Beachbody's been in existence, and then the business part's been in existence. Those are two different. So Beachbody's been in existence, I think, 25 years. The business part's been in existence, I think, 15 years, I think. Don't quote me on that. And we know, just like with any other job, and I see it in my own team, that for whatever reason, coaches come into the business and then they float away. Let me ask you this. If you are a Team Beachbody coach building a Team Beachbody network marketing business, do you have coaches on your team who were once highly engaged and who are now not? Because I do. Coaches who've come into your business and now they've floated away. For a myriad of reasons, there's no judgment here. I'm simply stating a fact. We have coaches who come into our business and then they float away. My hope is that they came into the business and that they got what they needed in the season of life that they got it. Do I wish they would stay? Yes, because everything about this business, fitness, nutrition, community, personal growth, and income makes your life better. So I don't know why they float away. That's not mine to know, okay? That's not my journey. But here's what I know. Is they're out there. They're out there. Floating around. And it breaks my heart that someone might be floating around out there without a mentor, without a community, and somehow, some way, having a bad taste in their mouth about this incredible business that can change your life. If you are showing up on social media as authentically you, not performative, not what you think people want to hear, but as authentically you, and you're on a quest to find your people, I think we will also connect with some of those incredible humans out there who have sort of floated away, or whose coach has floated away, and they're out there. And they're out there looking for someone. There are people in this world who have sort of floated away, or whose coach has floated away, and they are out there wanting community, guidance, and to get back in touch with this journey. If you will show up on social media as authentically you, on a quest to find your people, not performing, not saying what you think other people want to hear, those people may find you because they're out there. I have a lot of customers now in transition waiting to become coaches because their own coach had floated away and they just want to be part of a community. They want to get back into this business. And they will come and I am, you have no idea. You have no idea how it makes me feel when someone comes to me and goes, I used to be a coach. I left the business. I want to get back. Can I join your team? And I'm like, get in here. Get back. Get back. So if you can just show up on social media the way that communicates who you are authentically, with boldness, with kindness, there, not only are you going to find new people, but you're going to find those people who are out there who for whatever reason floated away and they want to come back. And Bree, I'm going to tell you, listen, you're about to get some Wednesday truth, love. Get over yourself. Because here's a yes or no question for you. Do you like every single human being on the planet that you come into contact with? That is a yes or no question. Do you like every single human being on this planet that you come into contact with? That's a yes or no question. The answer is already no. No, you don't. There are 7 billion people on this planet. Of course you don't like every single person that you come into contact with. Well, hi, newsflash, why would every single person like you? Why is it okay that you don't like every single person, but not okay that every person doesn't like you? It works both ways. We are creatures of energy. We're on a quest to find our people. We're on a quest to find that energy that aligns with us. We're on a quest to find the people who vibe with us. Not everyone vibes with us. Newsflash, we don't vibe with everyone. You're telling me right now, you're telling me that you can't think of a single person that you don't like right now? Because I can. And it's not that you don't like them as a human being or that they don't matter as a human being. It's just that your energies don't vibe. You just don't vibe with them. So why would they vibe with you? Why is that okay? You don't like everyone. Everyone's not going to like you. Not everyone got your memo of what you want to do with your life. So show up on social, in real life, every place you can, as the real, authentic you, not the performative you, not the you that's trying to cater to someone else's opinions, not the you who's toning down, not the you who's dimming your light, none of that. And when you do that, you can find your people, your new people, the people who are out there floating around, who need connection. Like, you're looking for your people your entire life. Some people will vibe, some people will not. And we all go on about our merry way, right? Oh, wow, look. See, where is it? Look. So cool. Okay, we've gone on longer than planned, so we're gonna wrap it up. But listen, I do have to share this with you. This is disappointing news. We are not going to LA this weekend. Josie is ill, and so we are not going. And I am a sad mom that I am not going. So we will probably have Energize Live tomorrow because I will not be in LA. And so I'm a sad mom about that. But we will go in a couple weeks when she's feeling better. And unfortunately, Jesse won't be able to go. And Jessie leaves for Toronto next week. And she can't, of course, she can't take a risk of getting COVID and then not being able to get on the ship. No one can take that risk. And, you know, Josie's been, she had a big move, lots of changes, new job, stress, all that kind of stuff. And so I'm sure her immune system was down a little bit. And she texted yesterday. And she's like, I feel like we both had it in May. She's like, I feel like we did in May and I have a fever and da-da-da. And I'm like, the timing, but it is what it is. So we are not going this weekend. We will reschedule. And I think we might go in a few weeks when it's my husband's birthday. And what's kind of cool about that is my husband's always been in football season for his birthday. So we may go to California for his birthday. And then we'll be at Disneyland on his birthday. You know, so, okay. I know that there are some other questions we didn't get to. Maybe you can bring them, tomorrow, and, I think we'll be back tomorrow because I will not be in LA. So, yeah, send good vibes to her and hopefully she gets better soon and we'll be out in LA in a few weeks, we hope. So, okay. Go make it a great Wednesday. Today's August 3rd. Go show up on social media as authentically you. Go put out the vibes that you're looking for your people. Go find your people, find your community, create your community, and let's do good work today, shall we? Every day is a good day to create magic, so let's go do that. Happy Wednesday.